This video will do an example of impulse in the chapter related to momentum, conservation momentum. Let's suppose a person has a tennis ball coming into the racket and leaving the racket. The tennis ball is going to have a mass of 0.12 kilograms. The ball leaves the racket with a speed of 30 meters per second. And this is the case where the ball is bounced off vertically off of the surface of the tennis court. So in the horizontal direction, the ball had zero velocity before the impact occurred. And we're only going to worry about the horizontal velocity of the tennis ball in this example. So we have the tennis ball leaving the racket after the collision is done with the racket, 30 meters per second. And the racket's mass is given. You may or may not want to use that for the calculation. The length of the racket is 0.7 meters. You may or may not want to use that in the calculation. The ball was in contact with the racket, the netting of the racket, for 0.06 seconds. We want to calculate the impulse. Well, the impulse is force multiplied by the length of the collision, the time of the collision. So we don't know the force that the tennis racket applied to the ball. We do know the time, but there's another way of doing this calculation rather than having to know the force or the time, and that is using the fact that impulse equals the change in the momentum. So the change in momentum, this delta, means momentum final minus momentum initial. The initial momentum in the horizontal direction was zero. So that simplifies our calculation. We just need to use the final momentum, mass times velocity, 0.12 kilograms times 30 meters per second, and we find 3.6 kilograms meters per second. That's the impulse that was given to the tennis ball. Now that we know that, we can use the time information and calculate the average force. Newton's second law here, the average external force applied to the tennis ball, is equal to the change in the momentum of the tennis ball divided by the length of the collision. So delta P over delta T, we get 3.6 divided by 0.06. We find 60 newtons. That was the force, the average force, of this collision of the tennis racket and the tennis ball. Of course, the force started near zero. The force peaked, maybe double this, maybe more. And then the force relaxed as the ball started to leave the netting of the tennis racket. The force during the collision was variable. This impulse calculation gives us the average force. So 60 newtons found by doing delta P, the change in momentum, divided by the length of the collision.